Good evening, everyone. This is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. Everyone, this is Katz from Yokoso News. Today is the Tuesday, August 9th, 2011. It's about 8:32 p.m. Japan Standard Time. And if you guys know, I'm trying to think. So apologize for the 30 minutes delay for the show because one of our guests, Taka-san from Fukushima, Japan, he is editing the video as he kind of promised to put it, but he's working hard right now, trying to upload the video right now, so I kind of waited for him. Then I hope he can come in time. Here we go.
Music by Kevin MacLeod.
Alright, so everyone, Yokoso News is usually an online website to introduce Japanese culture in English. Like, if you come to yokosonews.com, it's full of World Cosplay Summit 2011 coverage that you can see. Last weekend, 34 cosplayers from 17 countries represent their country and perform the cosplay. Cosplay is the, you know, it's like you dress up like anime character or game character, then perform as if they were the game character. So it's really fun. You know, not only, it's not, you know, you get to dress up. It's like a giant, you know, Halloween party. You know, it's like an exaggeration. Halloween party, 365 days. So you can see that many cosplay. And I was able to like talk to many cosplayer from all over the world too. And yesterday, it was an 8-hour day long livecast. Toba Hanzaki Matsuri. Hanzaki Matsuri is the giant salamander festival. So we did the 8-hour long live cast of the Japanese festival. And it was fun as well. So we usually broadcast those stuff. However, since March 11th, earthquake, tsunami, and Fukushima nuclear power plant crisis, I've been dedicated part of my content to giving you the update of what's happening in Japan since the March 11th. So this is the weekly update of that March 11th. So for the I like you guys know in about for 8 hours from now, I will be appearing Al Jazeera the stream. So if you happen to be on, you know, if you are free in 8 hours from now, which is the 3:30 p.m. Eastern. 12:30 p.m. Pacific, 3:30 p.m. Eastern, 7:30 p.m. GMT, or 4:30 a.m. Japan Standard Time. I will be appearing live on Al Jazeera, the stream. They wanted to interview me about what's happening in Japan, the update. So, please check us out. Okay. And so, yeah, I haven't really see Hide-san is ready or not. Alright, so I'm just gonna go ahead with the regular update of today. Today is the August 9th, 2011, Tuesday night, Japan Standard Time. IT Glab. Image is a little bit too dark, I think. No, it's okay. I mean, this is just a more likely radio program-like style that I happen to accomplish, because this is not 100% image-driven. I mean, you don't really have to look at my face. So, if you have any question during the live, if you're watching this live, you can log on to the social timeline and leave us any comment through Twitter, Facebook, AOL, or MySpace. Oh, yeah. Then, if you are watching this at the archive, you are welcome to send us an email. Please go to contact hyperlink on the top right of the page, and then you can send us a feedback. And please don't forget to like us, Tati Okosu News, on Facebook, or follow us, Tati Okosu News, on Twitter. So if something happened in Japan-related stuff, I will also tweet or post the stuff on the Facebook, and or, you know, that kind of stuff. All right, so the update of today, August 9th, 2011. So, again, as last weekend was the World Cosplay Summit coverage that I had to do. I mean, I didn't have to do, but I wanted to do, and because everybody... But anyway, I'm trying to give them feedback and everything, but... So, between August 2nd and August 9th, what happened this week? Pretty much the top story of Japan was about the economy, you know, because of the Standards and Poor's rating over the United States federal government bonds has been decreed, you know, like downgraded from AAA to AA+. We lost, economy is kind of got affected huge, especially the US dollar exchange, US dollar yen exchange rate. So, top news has been always kind of like that in the last couple days. But on August 6th and August 9th, we just had the 66th anniversary of an atomic bomb in Nagasaki and Hiroshima. And today, it was a day of Nagasaki atomic bombing. So at about 11 o'clock, 11:02 a.m., that's the time that Nagasaki bomb was dropped 66 years ago in Nagasaki, Japan. They had the ceremony. I was watching it live. They were live on the Ustream. You might have known because I kind of tweeted the link. Mayor of Nagasaki mentioned for the first time that we have to, he said that we have to come up with the alternative energy source to replace the nuclear power energy. It has been a huge debate. The mayor's message has been considered by 17 experts, college professors or victim of a survivor of a atomic bomb. Those 17 people have been kind of revising mayor's message to the world during this peace ceremony, and then they were debating if they should include the Fukushima incident or not, and they end up including it, and they end up saying that we should start, as a country who has been affected by the atomic bomb, we have to also start thinking about the alternative power we don't have to completely depend on the nuclear power. So that's what they end up saying today. And, Hiroshima, Hiroshima message, where is it? I have to find the Hiroshima message. Yeah. And Hiroshima, where is Hiroshima message? Ta-ta-ta-ta-ra. Yeah, same thing. Hiroshima said same thing, that in the Hiroshima peace ceremony last Saturday, August 6th, mayor of Hiroshima said the same thing. Mayor Matsui-san, as a country that who has been bombed, and then also learned the lesson from the radiation from our own past, it is so sad that that we created another victim and then threat of the radiation, and we have to make sure that we will try to abandon the nuclear weapon, and we have to pursue the world without nuclear weapon, we already know that we have to revise the safety of we have to revise the our mindset of the safety against the nuclear energy, and we also have to build towards the society that's not won't be dependent from the nuclear power. And both Hiroshima and Nagasaki peace ceremony, they both invited people from Fukushima, and some of them are, evacuating to Hiroshima or Nagasaki because they had to evacuate and start up as well. Okay, Ustream is experiencing some stream problem, had a couple of 1 second delay. Okay. I'm using the new software that the Ustream Japan gave me to the test, so it could be that as well. I kind of wanted to test the new stuff too. Okay. So that's the that's like top news for this week. And so many festival is happening in Japan, and everybody trying to kinda not forget, but forget for a moment and moving on. That's kinda what happened during this weekend in the most of Japan. But we did, you know, we did take seriously about the anniversary of the Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So that's pretty much it. Alright, cool. So let me go to the smaller update of Fukushima nuclear power plant crisis. Last week of the news was they found a high amount of the radiation spot. And soon after I finished last week, weekly update, they found two additional spot. Now they start thinking about this week. They start thinking about bringing the people down. They're thinking about lifting the evacuation order, and they start thinking about calling people back to the Fukushima, around the Fukushima nuclear power plant, because according to TEPCO, Japanese government, NISA, it's now the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant is getting safer. And delay are getting more frequent. How about IT Gleb? How about the other Ustream channel? Can you check other Ustream channel is okay or not? So let me go through a quick, short update. As on August 9th at about 5 p.m., according to police department, the total death toll of total deaths and missing toll from March 11th disaster are 20,444 people. Confirmed deaths are 15,687. And there are about 4,757 people are still missing. Again, earlier today, Nagasaki had a peace ceremony, and about 6,000 people attended the peace ceremony. But this year, for the first time, the representative of the United States government, Mr. Zumwalt, I don't know their his official title is, but he has attended the peace ceremony in Nagasaki. So it is kind of remarkable that United States government representative. Attended the peace ceremony of Nagasaki. And August 9th. Okay, and as you guys know, because in Japan, many, not only Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, many other people, many other nuclear power plant also stop their services because of the concern among the local people. So this year, Japanese electric company are having hard time trying to come up with the enough power supply without so much nuclear power plant. So Tohoku EPCO, the power plant that's been serving the North Japan area, their capacity has the electricity usage of their region has reached 98% of their capability. So if they reach more than 100%, they go blackout. You know, the entire region of North Japan could go blackout. So Tohoku EPCO was actually in a state of the emergency, was almost going to become a state of emergency to have a shortage of the electricity in North Japan. However, TEPCO is going to provide more electricity support to the Tohoku EPCO. So hopefully this will be okay. But so Tohoku EPCO is the electric company that's been affected most influenced by the shortage of the electricity due to the less nuclear power plant generating the power, but also the TEPCO itself, Chubu Electric Company, Kansai EPCO, all the electric company in Japan are suffering from the shortage of the electricity during this summer. Especially as you guys might know, this is really hot summer again, as much as last week. Secretary General of United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, actually visited Japan, and he met with Prime Minister Naoto Kan, but also he visited the Fukushima and cheer the people up, the people who live in the shelter. That's on August 7th. In August 2nd, Toyota Motor Corporation announced its balance sheet of the first quarter from the April to June. They are in deficit. They lost about almost 108 billion yen in between April and June. But they are fixing their factory in Tohoku area quicker than they thought. So hopefully they will be able to get back the full production and then recover from the damage by the earthquake. And one of the concern about the Tohoku North Japan is also the education. If the people, kids in Tohoku area received enough education or not. So the many other teachers, organizations are trying to help educate people. So according to Yomiuri, city of Yokohama is going to send total thousand people to the Ishinomaki, and they will do like additional after school program to help cover the loss of the tea education that they couldn't receive because of the disaster. This is the news on August 2nd from Yomiuri. And this is on August 3rd, according to TV Tokyo, NHK, and Yomiuri. You might remember the image of the oil refinery of Chiba exploded and burned. So last week on August 3rd, the Cosmo Sekiyu, that's the oil refinery, the company or the oil energy company, which the oil refinery factory burned down, held the tour to the press to show it to the damage of the oil refinery explosion. So according to Cosmo Sekiyu, it took them 10 days to cease the fire. The cause of the fire was because when they are some of the tank that they were not using, they were filled with water in order to clear up the gas. So the gas tank that usually contains the gas, LPG gas, but in order to do the maintenance, they filled with the water. So the gas tank was the weight of the gas tank was twice as heavy as the regular state. That's when earthquake happened. The gas tank couldn't hold the weight of the water, so gas tank fall, and it damaged the surrounding pipe, and also it damaged the electric device. So that caused the explosion. And so that led the explosion of four tanks. Three tanks made a hole, and 17 tanks surrounded by got burned down. So, so according to Cosmo Sekiyu, they are trying to fix the oil refinery by this fall, but they will also consult with the neighbor, if they can resume the operation after enough explanation. And also, there is a lot of scam going on. According to the police department, on August 4th, from March 11th to the end of July, there has been 65 scams in 22 prefecture that they stole the total of 3.4 million yen. So that's include somebody tried to collect money on the street for the donation, and also there are some scam that like loaning scam. And investments, some kind of scam. So the police department warns the people to be careful with those scam relate to March 11th disaster. And then, according to Ministry of Land, they on August 5th they said that the total amount of the houses that has been completely destroyed is now end up being over 120,000 building, and that's the building completely destroyed, and total 220,000 building has been damaged by this March 11th disaster. So, among those data that they analyzed, if the area got swiped with tsunami, more than 2 meters of the height got the most damage. So, the area where the tsunami height was 1.5 to 2 meters, only 34% of the building was completely destroyed. The area where they had 2 to 2.5 meters of tsunami was destroyed, more than 72%. So with current building code, we have to be careful with the area that they might experience the more than 2 meters of tsunami or flooding. So that's the area where the building may get the affected. And there are about 556 people who got canceled their job. And then okay. And then according to 556 students who almost got hired by a company, their employment contract was canceled according to Ministry of Labor on October 5th. And according to Japan's cabinet member, on August 5th, in June, there are 16 people who commit suicide in June, which suicide were seemed to relate to the disaster. Yeah, so that's pretty much the update of the earthquake. Let me go to the nuclear power plant update. Is anybody having this Ustream problem besides IT Glaive? If you guys too having the same issue, I might consider restarting right now. But if nobody else is having the issue, then I will continue. Is Ustream having problem? Let's see. Okay, Mark, you don't have any problem. Okay, so maybe IT Glab, it's your connection that's having problem, maybe? Okay, so I'm streaming with 800 kilobps of the bandwidth. So let me go to the so Mark, my stream is loud and clear, right? All right, cool. So let me move on then. So this is going to be Fukushima nuclear power plant related update. On August 4th, Tokai TV, which based in Nagoya. They have a kind of variety information like program called Pecan TV. On August 4th, they made a kind of terrible mistake that when they were going to announce the winner of their sweepstakes, they said that when they announced the winner of the sweepstakes, they mistakenly display the dummy names, which name was Mr. Cesium, Mr. Contaminated Cesium. So it was nothing has really joke and mistake. But they received so much complaints, and then it kind of created a scandal. The media people, although it was a joke, it was kind of senseless. So that happened on August 4th. Sand of the moon. It looks okay here. You're from Belgium. Okay, thank you. Did you change something lately? Delays are gone by now. No, IT Glab, I didn't change anything. I think it could be your network or network in between the Ustream server and you. So, seems like other viewers have no problem watching this show. So okay. Oh shoot. Hey, okay, I deleted it. Okay, this is not that. Okay, then August 6, 2011, water contamination of the ocean around the second nuclear power plant and third nuclear power plant of Fukushima Daiichi power plant, nuclear power plant, has increased a little bit. Around the second nuclear power plant's water gate, they detect 0.65 becquerel per cc of the cesium-134 and 0.72 becquerel per cc of cesium-137, where the place that it used to have like 1.1 million times legal limit of the cesium. And up to August 2nd, they kept decreasing the amount of the radioactive contamination of the water around the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. But from August 2nd to August 6th, the ocean contamination around the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant has little bit increased little. So near the third third reactor of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant's water gate, cesium-134, they detect about 1.2 becquerel per cc and 1.3 becquerel per cc of cesium-137. According to TEFCO, this rise of the ocean contamination is very little, and they don't think that this is caused by additional leakage of the contaminated water. So that's what the on August 4th, this is a long old story from the last week. So they start having the study group how to decommission, how to clean up the site of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So, with TEPCO and Japanese government and all the experts. So, Nuclear Safety Commission of Japan, on August 3rd, they formed a new study group to discuss how to decommission Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant after the incident is getting secure, and they start talking about a how to clean up the stuff. So the Japanese government and experts start talking about how to clean up the land of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So I guess it's an improvement, right? And on August 4th, according to NHK, hey, Prosper Beer, good to see you. Prosper Beer. So on August 4th, Sukagawa, Japan, Sukagawa, Fukushima, they are going to start testing the rice. As Taka-san from iBreezeIwaki.net, which I'm actually waiting for him to come on board, as he's still editing the video to report. But his family is growing the rice, but the concern of the farmers are that if they can still produce the rice and sell it to people so that they can pay their bills. But they have nothing, they can't do anything but keep growing the rice. But they also don't want to grow the rice that's radioactive contaminated. So according to Sugakawa City, Fukushima, they said they are going to start testing some kind of measurement to use the kalium to reduce the amount of the radioactive contamination. So okie doke. So today on August 9th, Japanese government is held the meeting, and they might start think they are going to lift evacuation order that has been issued more than 20 kilometers outside of 20 kilometers radius. The emergency evacuation from the 20 kilometer to 30 kilometers radius or more, they have set this evacuation preparatory region, the zone. But they said they're going to, Japanese government said that they will be canceling that emergency evacuation preparatory zone today. And also, previously, up to now, the residents who are outside from 3 kilometers radius from Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant could go back home under the supervision of the government, but within 3 kilometer zone, they could not go back because Japanese government think it's too dangerous for the residents. So, but as Japanese government thinks the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant is getting more like safer, according to Japanese government TEPCO. They kind of need to let the residents who has a house within 3 kilometers of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant to be able to go back home and get their belongings. Okay, Prosper Beer sounds having hard time. What's you can. Sorry. Well, I think I need, if because many other people are not having an issue, so I think I'm going to carry on. Okay. So, on August 9th, 2011, Nuclear Safety Commission of Japan and Nuclear Industry Safety Agency has been accused for controlling the public opinion. So, I don't know if it's like last week or a couple weeks ago that NISA or NSA, Nuclear Safety NSC, they've been trying to manipulate people's opinion by engaging the nuclear power plant related company employee to attend the conference. And then send an email to like public debate TV program to influence the, you know, opinion and stuff. So METI, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Economy, Industry and Technology just launched the kind of investigation group. And they held the first meeting. So this investigation study group is going to conduct the hearing to the Nuclear Safety Commission members and then Nuclear Industry Safety Agency members, and to investigate further opinion control stuff. All right. On August 9th, according to Fukushima Prefecture Educational Board, there are about 14,000 students, 14,000 elementary and middle school students are going to transfer outside of Fukushima Prefecture, which is about 10% of the students. In Fukushima Prefecture, there are about 165,000 elementary and middle school students. So 14,000 students means 10% of the elementary school and middle school students are transferring outside of the Fukushima Prefecture. That shows the concern of the Guardian against the threat of the radiation. And those guardians tend to have more money to, or more money opportunity to relocate themselves to the outside of Fukushima, I guess. Oh, okay. IT Gleb, as I could figure out, the problem is at the Limelight Network, who handled the stream to Europe. Oh, okay. Got it. So, okay. All right, Pros, can you, ID Glib, can you help the Prosper Bear to watch my archive? I will post it onto the YouTube within a couple hours I finish this live cast. So, he could watch the archive onto the YouTube. So let's actually ask him this question when if Taka could join us. On August 9th, Hiroshima Prefecture is going to help 240 evacuees who evacuated from Fukushima to help them test internal radiation exposure. So it's called whole body counter method. It cost about 20,000 yen per person to test the amount of the internal radiation exposure, but the Hiroshima Prefecture said their prefecture is going to assist the evacuees from Fukushima to pay for the checkups today. Oh, then this is the kind of small stuff, but kind of huge, the people's fear. So, I don't know if you know, in August, every August 16th, in Kyoto, Japan, they burn the pine tree alongside of the mountain with the shape of a kanji character to pay the respect of the ancestors. And then they were planning to use the pine tree from North Japan. However, internet users and the people of Kyoto complained that they are afraid of the radiation contamination of the pine tree that they are going to bring into Kyoto. So that they're called Okuribi, the festival committee member of the Okuribi decided to cancel using the pine tree from Rikuzen Takada, Iwate Prefecture. but the experts denouncing that decision that they have no scientific reason. There's no way those even those pine tree maybe they tested the radiation contamination of the pine tree and they didn't see any of the cesium contamination. And then experts are, you know, denouncing that decision that made by the people of Kyoto. On August 8th, in Minami Soma, Fukushima, according to Yomiuri, they have started to clear up the surface of the soil at elementary school in Minami Soma to reduce the amount of the radioactive contamination of the soil of school. So in most of the Japanese school, they use the soil for their school ground, and the school grounds of the around the Fukushima schools, they most likely to have the radiation contamination. But with couple experiment and test, they could reduce the large amount of the radiation. So Minami Soma, Fukushima, they are going to start a more large scale surface cleaning. Okay. And August 5th, according to TEPCO, in the central water processing facility where they store some of the contaminated water, they found that about 700 liters of contaminated water had leaked from the hose. On October 5th, according to TEPCO, so they leaked about 700 liter of contaminated water. Those waters contamination was about 5.5 million becquerel per centimeter of cesium-134. And 6.2 million becquerel per centimeter square meter and 6.2 million becquerel per square meter of cesium 137 of the contaminated water had been leaked from the horse. Okay. And according to Ministry of Labor, on August 3rd, they are going to launch a database to monitor the health condition of workers who work on the site of Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So, this database will be maintained for decades, and they will collect the data so that they can use the information to use it for the future health reason. So this database that the Japanese government is going to launch, they are going to monitor the typical worker one by one. They are going to enter the radiation exposure, external radiation exposure, internal radiation exposure, what kind of work they did, what kind of the health check, how much alcohol they drink, how much smoke they had, and then while they are working for the TEPCO, working at the TEPCO or contracting company, company is responsible of providing those data. After the certain worker has left the company, Japanese government will voluntarily ask those worker to provide the health data. So those employees who provide the data, they will be issued the kind of a registration card, and they will be able to check their history whenever they want. And if the worker has exposed to more than certain amount of the radiation, Japanese government is going to pay for the health check. That's the All right, cool. So Japanese government is trying to monitor the health check of the people. Workers. And on August 3rd, Japanese government passed a law to launch the some kind of the institution. It's called Genshiryoku Songai Baisho Shien Kikou in Japanese. But it is the institution run by the Japanese government. Direct translation is Nuclear Damage Payment Support Institution or something. Supporting institution or something. So Japanese government passed a law to launch that institution. This government institution is going to help assist TEPCO to pay the damage payment to the victim of the Fukushima nuclear crisis. And they're also going to supervise the financial of the TEPCO. Alright, cool. So, yeah. And on August 4th, Chiba Prefecture said that they are going to start testing the radioactive contamination level of their rice. In Chiba Prefecture, according to Yomiuri. And on August 5th, in Shizuoka Prefecture, they once found the radioactive contamination of their green tea. However, on August 5th, their green tea has been radioactive contamination free. So the shipping restriction of the tea of Shizuoka have lifted on August 5th. So according to Shizuoka Prefecture, their green tea are safe to drink. But on the other hand, as you know, there is a concern against the possible radioactive contamination of the beef meat, because the rice straw that was produced in Miyagi Prefecture was contaminated by the radiation, and then some of the cow ate that contaminated rice straw, and those meat has been a little bit meat has been radioactively contaminated. So according to City of Yokohama, about 19 cows, meat of the 19 cows from Fukushima, Miyagi, Iwate has been used to 127 schools in your city of Yokohama, about for the 67,000 kids. And so those meat may be fed to 67,000 elementary school kids might have eaten radioactive contaminated meat in between April 19th and June 21st, about 12 times, according to City of Yokohama, according to Yomiuri. So the beef has been used as a hatched beef or dry curry. They have not been tested for the radiation test. The amount of those meat was about 25 to 40 gram of meat per dish. According to City of Yokohama, the amount of the beef that they ate, it was not that much. So they don't think that it would be the much of the risk to the health. So yeah, Prosper beer is All right. So, yeah. So the concern among the parents are huge. I can imagine. And then, according to Yomiuri newspaper. Thank you. According to Yomiuri newspaper, it's reporting about the concern by the local government and also testing institute that so many people and so many government and so many organization wants to test the radiation contamination, but you know, they can only test so much. So they are concerning that if they cannot process enough amount to test the food contamination. So that's the concern of the Yomiuri. That's the concern that the Yomiuri reported on August 8th. So that's pretty much it. So everyone, this is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. Today I've been doing the 311 disaster update number 47 on Tuesday, August 9th, 2011, live from Yokkaichi Mie, Japan. Apologize, I've been working non-stop since more than non-stop since Thursday, because I had to cover World Cosplay Summit starting Thursday, and then I also went cover like Hanzaki Matsuri, Giant Salamander Festival yesterday. I talked about 8 hours, and I'm still taking care of the after, you know, post coverage of the editing of the World Cosplay Summit 2011. It was fun, but now I'm getting tired and losing much of the concentration, but I'm trying to do my update right now because I will be on Al Jazeera English, the stream, which is in about 6 hours. I will be live in about 6-7 hours from now. So some of you might be watching this archive after you watch the stream, but folks, I will be on Al Jazeera's English channel, the stream. The URL is stream.aljazeera.com, and I will be live, and they will also repeat a couple times, I think, and you can watch live, or you will be able to watch the archive at from their website. Okay, so everyone, thank you very much for okay. I'm talking to Taka from in Fukushima, Japan. I'm waiting for him to come. Yeah, today it's kind of relaxing, lazy, not lazy, but relaxing kind of show. Talking to Taka-san from Fukushima, Japan. Okay, I'm talking. Takasan has been working, trying to finish the video, but it seems like he's. I'm still talking to him right now. So I have a live report from Fukushima, Japan. Waiting for Taka-san to... Alright, everyone, this is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japan more. But I've been doing the... Usually Yokoso News provide the fun stuff, entertainment stuff, like World Cosplay Summit.
Entertainment stuff, like...
Dajoubu?
Okay desu.
Oish.
Konbanwa.
Konbanwa. So, dajoubu desu yo. Like entertainment stuff, like World Cosplay Summit 2011, that you can check the coverage from yokosonews.com, but or and also YouTube channel. But because in order to for you guys to enjoy the Japanese culture, I also have to report during the crisis, you know. To make sure that you guys are safe, you guys are well informed if the crisis happens. So that has been the fundamental policy of the Yokoso News. So since March 11th, I've been doing this emergency broadcast. First of all, it was every day, now weekly, and try to give you that stuff now. So now we are welcoming. We are welcoming the Taka-san from iBreeze Iwaki, and he's going to talk to us about the update of Japan this week. Taka-san, あのさ、
はい。
あの、編集はどっちでやってるんですか？
編集はですか？
うん。
編集は Mac Pro です。
で、今その Mac Pro でアクセス、スカイプしてるんですか？
iMac です。
ああ、違う Mac なんや。
はい。あ、ちなみにですね、
うん、
ムービーデータはもう出来上がってますので、
うん、
今、Ustream にアップ中なんですが、ことのほか時間がかかってますので、
うん、
データ自体はあるんですけども。
だからそれを、
はい、
Skype の画面共有で再生したらいいんじゃない？
ああ、なるほど。はい、はい。
ということ。
そういうことですね。
そういうこと。
わかりました。
じゃあ画面共有お願いします。
はい。
できますよね。
はい。
Okay. So now, last minute, he has been editing. He tried to upload it onto the website. So Taka-san is the professional videographer on i-breeze-iwaki.net. He has been providing the latest information of Japan, I mean Iwaki, Japan, Iwaki, Fukushima, Japan. So for the Japanese people. So I ask Taka-san if he wants to report something that happening in Fukushima, Japan that you wouldn't hear from the regular people. So. All right, じゃあ、じゃあ、タカさん。
はい。
So, what do you have today? じゃあ、今日の簡単な紹介をお願いします。
今日はですね、別な仕事の方に時間を取られておりまして、
はい。
アイブリーズ岩木の情報サイト並行して作業を進めてたんですが、
はい。
間に合
ってないです。もう大丈夫大丈夫。はい、言い訳はいいから本題行こう。
はい。
はい。ちょっとやっちゃいましょう。じゃあ、はい、トピックなんでしょう。
そうですね、まず、8月入りまして、いわき市の平というところで、うん、七夕祭りが行われました。
はい、So in Taira, Fukushi, Iwaki, Japan, they had a Tanabata festival. Tanabata is the July 7th festival where the male star meets the female star, across the Milky Way.So, some, you know, some places do it in a new calendar, but some people do it in Chinese calendar. So I guess Taira Fukushima is having the Tanabata festival according to Chinese calendar. So they just had it last weekend. Taira Tanabata Matsuri. So I can see on his website at ibreezeiwaki.net.I see these gorgeous picture from ibreezeiwaki.net. So these are このな、これな、何やったっけこれ、あの、七夕の飾り。
あ、これはですね、静岡県清水の方から、
うん、
まあ、送っていただいた。
So this is the, this was sent from the Shizuoka Prefecture as a gift to cheer up them.これ、この、この七夕の短冊自体の説明はなんです。What is this object itself? I know it's the donation from the Shizuoka, but the viewer don't even know what this object means. だから視聴者は分からん。これ自体がどんなものか知らないんで。
ああ、そうですね。まあ、七夕、要は短冊はですね、
うん、
まあ、多分静岡から送っていただいたのは、竹ですよね、竹。
うん、
うん、まあ、放射能汚染の問題があって、竹を地元の竹を使えないであろうというところから来てると思うんですが、うん、はい、あとまあ飾り付けにおいては毎年やっておりますので、商店街のお店が、うん、飾り付けをされていた。
短冊の意味ってこと、何短冊って何ってこと。
ああ、ははは、短冊はですね、まあ、あれですね、願い事を書いて、まあ、貼り付けることでこう願い事を成就させたいというものですよね。
Okay. So, as you can see, this big object, あれ、これも短冊なんですか、写真の。
ああ、これは短冊とは言わないですね。笹飾りですね。
笹飾りですよね。
はい。
はいはい。笹飾りって何ですかね。
笹飾り。
そうやね。
うん。
意味があるんやったっけ。
そうですね。
Okay, we both forgot what this object means, but we'll find out next year. まあ来年やね。だから正直言って竹とか。静岡から送られたとかそういうの関係なしに、もともと七夕祭り自体を知らんから、その説明しやんと。
なるほど、はいはい
はい。Anyway, so yeah, because we both are busy with our other work, so we are kind of came into the last minute that we realized that oh, we actually don't know what each region's festival mean, but Yeah, this is the handmade style reporting, everyone. And we kind of both are preoccupied with other work. But anyway, so this is the picture of the Tanabata Festival from Taira Fukushima that they had over the last weekend, you know. So this is the Sasakazari.So this is Tanabata usually have the decoration over the bamboo tree. I posted sometime, you know, on the Yokosu News Facebook page, the picture of the bamboo tree with bunch of the piece of paper, you know, people write down their like dream and hang it on the bamboo tree.But this is Sasakazari, it's also the decoration, the big decoration. that kind of celebrate Tanabata Matsuri and stuff. So that's what they had over the weekend. Yeah. Nice pictures. で、まあ、ページ見せてますから。はい。じゃあ、ビデオとか見せれます?
はい。ビデオはジャンガラになります。
So this is ジャンガラ。ジャンガラって何でしたっけ?
ジャンガラはですね、亡くなった人の魂を慰める念仏踊りです。
So Jangara is the Buddhist dance to kind of calm the soul down of the deceased ancestors. So this is the video that Taka-san shot last weekend. So especially this year, many people, unfortunately, many people have passed away. So, this year they really work their way to do the dancing. So there are about 10 groups join this Jangara Buddhist dance, and then they, each group has its own unique style of Buddhist dance and taiko drum tempo. And also they also ring the bell and they dance around. So let's see how they do. あれ?もう映像流れとるはず?
はい、流れてます。
わー、止まっとるな。OK。はい、OK、OK です。もうあのさもうちょっと画面小さくしていただけます？
あ、小さく、
OK。
月またに平成23年3月11日午後2時46分空前の巨大地震突如として東日本の大地を揺るがせ無常の霊は倒壊家屋の瓦礫を下す今ここに東日本大震災の惨状を目の当たりにして震災独者の王朝浄土を願い速やかに極楽浄土へた
ま
ん
もうちょっと小さくしてくれます。
あかりに長くは行方不明者の発見救出と被災者各への安穏を
ストップ。はい、再生。Yeah, I don't really see much of the movement here. Apologize for the last minute report, everyone. This is Yokosu News, yokosunews.com. You are seeing the Buddhist dance, the kind of freezing video, because we couldn't do it at the last minute. So, yeah, we'll post it, the actual video later on. You'll be able to see on ibreezeiwaki.net. But so you can kind of see a little bit of the freezing video right now. But this group of the people are doing the Buddhist dance to pray for the deceased people. This is the called Jangara dance. Jangara dance. Jangara means the just the sound of this drum and then bell. That's just, it doesn't really mean anything, but just the sound of the Jangara. So that's what it is. And people dance like this. This is the kids Jangara dance group. And this is is the another Jangara group from Shimo Ogawa Jangara. Cool. Sounds good. Taka-san.
Hi.
ありがとうございました。
はい。
ちょっと動きも鈍いからさ。
ああそうですか、
うん、もうこの、はい、こんな感じにしときましょう、ほしたらね、
はい、じゃあ止めますね、
はい、はい、ありがとうございます。 Thank you very much to Taka さん。
はい、
So Taka さん、can I ask you a question? So I will be on the I will be on the Al Jazeera the stream tomorrow morning and they ask me three questionsthat they pretty much want to ask me about tomorrow. So, what is, do you think, let me, we, these question I asked previously to you, but I'm going to ask you again anyway. So, do you think a Japanese government is giving you the accurate information?Or what is your reaction to that? あの、タカさん。
はい。
その、実はまた明日の朝にね。
はい。
アルジャジーラに出るんですよ。
あ、はい。
言いましたよね。
はい、メールで伺います。うん、
あの、で、あの、いくつか質問してきてるんですけど。
はい。
まあ、福島の人に近いという Since you are living in 福島 You can ask those questions だ福島にお住まいということで、
はい、
その日本の政府に対する信用っていうのはどんな感じでしょうかね。ザックバランに
ザックバランにですか、
うん、あその政府の関係者とかがその情報をきちっと流してるとか、あの別にそのなんていうのかな、タカさん自身でもいいですけれども、まあ、福島のいわきの方全般的な印象というかどんな感じでしょうね。 Not only you I mean of course with you personally but the people of Fukushima surrounded in by you what do you think the feeling of how people are feeling towards the Japanese government providing the informationどんな感じでしょう。
そうですね、まあ、政府の報道については、結局その、まあ、信用できないという声が多いですよね。
うん、so pretty much the、もうほぼ全員って感じですよね、ほしたらね。
うん、そうですね、まあ、私的には 99% ぐらいじゃないかというイメージを言ってます、ね、
so 99%of the people of Fukushima, the in the Taka-san's opinion, 99% of the people of Fukushima don't trust the government. じゃあ政府が発表するそういうものってどう捉えてるんですか。So why? So what? How the people conceive the information that Japanese government release? For example, They just announced that they are going to lift the evacuation preparatory order zone. What do you think about that? だから例えば今日その避難準備区域を解除するとか言ってるじゃないですか。
はい。
そういうことに対してはどうなんでしょうね。
あの例えば今私が住んでいるいわき市南部については、
うん、
そういう対象エリアではないので、
うん、
またその住んでいる住民のこう感情とか感覚っていうのは結構違うばらつきがあると思うんですね、
うん、
でもあのやはりこう当該地域に住んでいる方なんか特にそうですけども、どうしてこう解除できるかっていう具体的な理由付けっていうのがないので、科学的な根拠がないので、
うん、
で仮にまあ科学的根拠というかそういう数値を示されても、
うん、
これまで後手後手になってきて、すべてこう当初の発表が覆されるデータが出てきてますので、
うん、
そういう意味で非常に 心配不安という形でしか残らないと思うんですよね。
Even like Japanese government said that、the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant is safe, but、the local people already, you know, have experience in the past that Japanese government reversed the data already, that they used to be the number is low.But it turned out to be bigger. And then also, even they said that they're going to lift the evacuation preparatory order, they don't present scientific explanation much. And Japanese media don't really report that scientific explanation why they decided to lift.The evacuation preparatory order. Why they decided that the people can come into within 3 kilometer zone of Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So because of that, 99% of the people in Fukushima just don't trust.The people, I mean, what the Japanese government said. それで、それでですね、
お、はい、
ちょっと待って、
はい、
それでですね、
はい、
なんや、あ。じゃあ最近その放射能汚染が拡大してきたじゃないですか。
はい、
先週もその so there is a threat of the rise of the radiation threat in the last couple weeks. So what is the reaction to that? 今までその放射能の汚染が高くなってきてるっていうのがあるんですけれども、それに関する皆さんのリアクションっていうのはどうなんでしょうかね。
そうですね、やはりですね、すでにカズさんもチェック済みのようでしたけども、例えば小中学生、
うん、
県内の小中学生なんかは、
うん
原発事故からこれまでの間に、
うん
県内で8000人、8000、まあ、9000人弱ですね、
うん、
の小中学生がすでに県、要は福島県から出てるんですよね、
うん
うん、で、まあ、それはいわゆるその保護者がそういった子どもの身を案じて、対応してるその、措置なわけですけども、うん、まああとはその社会的経済的いろんな理由があって出たくても出れないという人たちもたくさんいるわけなので、そういう意味では非常に何て言うんでしょうかね、もう政府があるいは県が発表するデータをそのまま真に受けてはいないということですよね。
うん、そうですよね。 So what's that as I reported that there are 10% of the elementary school kids are transferring outside of Fukushima prefecture. It kind of proves that parents are not trusting the government at all. So yeah, so.Yeah, that's I said. But, あ、タカさんすいません。
はい、
画面共有消してください。
はい、
はい。待機をセーブするために。
はい。
I just asked to cancel the screen share. Sorry. そうですね。で、How about you, タカさん。じゃあ、タカさんはザック・ブランに伺っていいですか？
はい。
どう、You are the parents of お子さん何名いらっしゃるんでしたっけ？
2名。僕は2人と中に。
2 and 1 pregnant. Okay, you're gonna have 3. Okay. So, you live in Iwaki, Iwaki, Fukushima, which is 40, 50 kilometers, 40 kilo, 50 kilo 圏外ですね。
そうですね。
You're 40, 50 kilometers away from Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, and your area is not the part of the evacuation zone. And you have two kids, with one unborn child coming up. If you have money and like if you have a resources, would you like to move out? じゃあ本当にざっくばらんにお伺いしたんですけど、
はい、
今の状態でもしもお金とお金とかがあったら、
はい
はい、福島の外出られたいです？今の環境で、今の与えられている情報とかで。
今の与えられている情報だけでは、そういったこう経済的に余裕があったとしても、
うん
うん、多分出るには至らないのかなと私は思います。
うん、For him,、among the information that he's provided,、he doesn't think that he need to leave いわき福島。じゃあ、今タカさんがいるいわき市の場所的にはいわき安全だと考えられてるってことですね。
うん、安全だとは考えてないんですけども。
うん。Well, so I ask him, is it, do you, so you think it's safe to continue to live in Iwaki, Fukushima where you live? And he said that he doesn't think it's safe much. 考えてないんですけど。
はい、考えてないんですけども、うん、即退避、例えば私たちが即避難しなければいけない、要素といいますか要因ですね、
うん、
それがどれほどのものなのかというところまでは、
うん、
至ってないのではないかと。あ、だからまだそうですね、すぐ避難しなきゃいけないレベルには至ってないのかなと今、うん、その汚染に関してはですね、
うん、
汚染に関しては
So in terms of the radioactive contamination, he thinks that they haven't reached the level that they need to evacuate right away. はい、
はい、ただ汚染に関してはそうであったとしても、
うん、
やはりこう先見性とか、うん、万が一ということを考えて、
うん、
まだ第一原発の、
うん、
処理というのは全然収束していないわけで、
うん、
日々冷却ポンプの故障であるとか、
うん、
そういったトラブルが、
うん、
連続して起こっている状態を鑑みると、
うん、
また余震のことも含めて、
うん、
いつまた、緊急避難しなければいけない状況が、
うん、
来ないとも限らない、
うん、つまり安息はできないという感じですね。
そうですね、常に。
つまりWhat he says that the reason why he doesn't think it's safe is because Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant hasn't resolved its issue completely. The water filtering system breaks all the time, stop functioning all the time.They haven't really figured out the exact schedule to completely finish the process, recovery or repair process of the Fukushima Daiichi. And then also he concerned about the continuous aftershock. He also concerned thatThese aftershock may damage the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant again and cause the unexpected accident and stuff in the future. はい。ですね。Yeah, so he's having uneasy light. But、at this point,、so it is okay to continue to live in Iwaki, Fukushima, where you are. まあでも今のところはそのいていいかなってことですね。
そうですね。
うん、
ただ、
うん、
やはり いわき市にもホットスポットに、まあ、ホットスポットのエリアがありますので、
うん、
その地域の方は、
うん、
その自分の住まいエリアを出てる方がたくさんいますので、
うんうん、
まあ、非常に複雑な思いですね、
うん、But, some part of the Iwaki Fukushima there is a hot spot.A hotspot that the radiation was a little bit higher than a other part of the area. So in that hotspot, many people left the that area. So as a resident of the Iwaki Fukushima, he has a little bit of the complex feeling towards the what's happening right now. ですね。はいはいはい。うん、まあでも今のところはじゃあということは今まあでもまあ心配しつつも
そうですね、うん、心配しつつもできる範囲で、まあ体内被曝を、
うん、
少しでもこう抑えられるような意識は、
うん、
持っていようかなというところですね。
So、he just tried to prevent from internal radiation exposure as much as possible. That's what、he tried to do right now. はい。 Such as? どういうことを具体的に、
はい、例えば、まあ、私たちもそうですけども、
うん、
子供たちも含めて、
うん、
これまで遊ぶのに公園とか屋外の公園とか、
うん、
遊んでいたわけですが、
うん、
まあ震災後は屋外の公園とか、
うん、
屋外で遊ばせることはなくなりました、う
ん、So、after the disaster、the parents never let kids play outside in Iwaki Fukushimaでもいわき市全体ってことですね。
そうですね。
もうじゃあ公園ガラガラ。So the park is completely empty then.
公園もそうですし、
うん、
ちょっとしたこう広場空き地なんかは、
うん、
見事に雑草が生い茂ってる状況になってますね。うん、
なるほどね。So、all the park or some kind of playgroundsthose area were left unmaintained, so many weeds are growing up, and then it's kind of miserable sight happening in Iwaki Fukushima right now. じゃあもういわき市全体の公園とか広場が雑草生えまくりのひどいというか状態なんでしょうか。
県立公園とか、
うん、
まあ、公園は公園でも大きいレベル、
うん、
常にこう管理者がいるような公園は、
うん、
整備されてますけども、
うん、
いわゆる本当にこう近所にあるような公園レベルは、
うん、
やはりこう雑草が生い茂っているようなところが多く見られますね。
なるほど。 So big park such as you know where they have like some kind of a management thereThose big parks are kind of maintained, but the small parks that maintained by the neighbors, those area tends to be untouched, unmaintained, and lots of weed are growing up, and then kind of, so no kids. まあとにもかくにも お子さんは全然遊ばれてないってことですね。そこら辺では。
うん、ただそこでまたまあ、複雑なのがですね。
うん、
外でバスケットボールをして遊んでる子供とか、
うん、
あるいは、うん、そうですね、まあ、ジョギングしてる子供とか、
うん、
いるんですね、
うん、But there are some kids playing the basketball outside or jogging outside. There are some kids there too. Well, kids want to play outside in Iwaki Fukushima, so they do there. Butas an adult, as a parent, those adults have a concern that, you know, so kids wants to play outside, but the parents kind of concerned. じゃあ、子供さんはもうとにもかくにも外で遊びたいと、子供だから。
見てる限りだと、
うん、
その、例えばまだ、なんていうんですかね、小学校未満 小学、要はあのそうですね、小学生に入っていないようなお子さんは、
うん、
保護者の判断で外で遊んでいないように見受けられますけども、うんうん、小学生以上中学生とかになると、
うんうん、
多分学校で、屋外活動を容認しているところもあるようなので、
うん、
その延長でやはり家に帰ってきても、
うん、
近所の、まあ、要は屋外で遊んでるというのが目につきますね。
まあ、つまり小学生以下は全然見やんってことですね、外で。
そうですね、まあ、簡単な散歩的なことは見受けますけども、
うん、
いわゆるこうこれまでのように、
うん、
遊ばせているという光景は限りなく少ないんですね、
う
ん
うん、So what they said that maybe when they hit the elementary school or middle school some of the school let kids play outside, so those kids continue to go outside. But preschool, up to 6 years old, most likely parents does not let the preschool kids to play outside as much as before. He does see some kids playing outside.But he doesn't really see it much right now. Okay. まあその状況でもまだ降り続けるって感じですよね。まだ降れるっていうことですよね。
そうですね。ただそう、そういうふうにこう外で遊ばないとか、
うん、
要は遊んでいるとか。
うん、
遊ばない人もいるし遊ぶ人もいるということは、
うん、
やはりさっきも言いましたように、
うん、
その本当の情報が見えないというところで、
うん、
そういうふうにもう個人の判断で、
うん、
大丈夫だろうという人は外で遊ぶし、
うん、
いや危険であろうと思う人は、
うん、
少しでもリスクを低く抑えたいので、
うん、
外では遊ばないという感じなのかなと思いますね。
So he feel that in Iwaki, Fukushima, parents, guardian are like trying to make the decision based on the information that they could get as much as possible. Then some parents let kids to go outside, some parents don't let kids to go outside just in case.So, yeah, so it's like, it's really like, now it's parents' responsibility and stuff, everything. Under the circumstance that many of the people in Fukushima seems that they don't believe what the government said at all. So, はい、じゃあ最後の質問なんですけど、最後の質問というかそんな感じなんですけれども、
はい、
今反原発の活動ってどんな感じです、福島で。 So last kind of part of the question, part last part, section of the question to you, what is like the anti-nuclear movement of that right now?反原発の活動とかどんな感じです、デモとかあったじゃないですか、
うん、そうですね、おとなしいんじゃないかと思えるぐらい、
うん、
そうですね、その強い大きなデモというのはないですね。
Yeah, he doesn't. Yeah, so Al Jazeera, producer asked me that, is there any demonstration going on in, you knowThen I also said no, I didn't hear anything, but I just want to make sure if there's any demonstration too. So I wanted to ask, yeah, もう福島周辺はないんですか？全く。
例えば、
うん、
なんて言うんでしょうかね、そのデモも全くないわけではないんですけども、うん、その もっとこう、その参加者が、
うん、
多くてもいいであろうと思われるような、
うん、
規模に収まっているという部分と、
うん、例えば最近ではやってるんですか？
最近ではいわきではないですね。
福島ではどんな感じです？
福島ではあの福島市とか郡山市とか、
うん、
そういったところで、まあ時折あるようですけども、
どんな何人規模、
いやそれも多分5、600人規模じゃないでしょうかね。
500、600 people demonstration happening in 福島 and 郡山。 What pace? どういうペースで、例えば 1ヶ月に1回とか1週間に1回とか毎日とか、
そういう継続性とかは感じられないですね。
He doesn't feel the frequency of that. Maybe just once in a while 500, 600 people demonstration、okay. まあでもある程度500、600人は来るってことですよね。でもそれでもまあ500、600人は来てるってことですよね。
どうでしょうね。
Do you think 500, 600 people is a lot of people or less people?
まああのデモのそのデモの性格といいますか、
うん、
まあ私も詳しくわからないんですけども、うん、例えばいわきであのノーニュークスというモアハーツという、うん、形でデモがあったときは、
うん、
いわきの人だけではないんですね。
うん、
郡山とか。
うん、
会津福島とか、
うん、
そういったところからも参加者の方がいたということを考えると、
うん、
まあ同じような人が、まあもちろん同じような人がやるんでしょうけども、
うん
うん、まあやはりこう割とこう限定されてしまってるのかなという感はありますね。
なるほど、うん、So the demonstration that he has been toyou know, pretty, for example, the demonstration in Iwaki, not only the people in Iwaki, but also the people of surrounding town has joined us. But people of surrounding town joined the demonstration, it's not that. Yeah, つまり、周り、その地域のじゃなくて、周りの人が参加してるのに、数が大きくならないということですよね。
そうですね。例えば、まあ立地というか、その例えばその福島県の、
うん、
やはりこうなんていうか社会的背景とか、
うん、
そういったものがあるので、あるためなんでしょうけども、
うん、
やはりその例えば東京の活動家の方たちは、
うん、
あるいはその県外の活動家の方たちは、
うん、
福島の人が立ち上がらなければ。
うん、
いけないよという声を持ってると思うんですね、
うん
うん、ただ、当事者の福島県の人間がどれだけ立ち上げてるかというと、声を大にして、
うん、
もう本当に積極的に活動されてる方はそれほど強くは感じないですね、
うん、So, he also hear thatmain, you know, most likely these kind of anti-nuclear movement are organized in the Tokyo. だつまり、まあ、反原発デモとか基本的に東京とかでやられてるってことですよね。で、それ、
そうですね。
So, mainly these anti-nuclear movement are happening in Tokyo area. However, the people organizer of these anti-nuclear organization want people of Fukushima themselves to stand out because they are the victim of the main victim of the nuclear power plant crisis. We don't think that people of Fukushima themselves stood out as much as those anti-nuclear organizer wants them to stand out. That's also probably have to do with the history of Fukushima, that Fukushima prefecture has been kind of made some money, or they kind of developed the industry because of the nuclear power plant industry and stuff too. じゃあつまりそれはまあ、あの福島の原発のおかげで雇用がされてたりとか補助金が来てるとかそういうことですよね。
そういうことはきっと往々にしてあるんでしょうね。
Yeah, we are not sure it, but we cannot deny the possibility. まあ じゃあ、うん、我慢してる。 So are they like being too patient? Like holding back? じゃあか、何ていうのかな、福島の人たちって例えば我慢されてるんですか？
表現が適切かどうか分かんないんですけども、うん、例えば、まあ、私はたまたまその、例えば原発作業員の友人とか、
うん、
親戚っていうのは限りなくいないんですよね。ただ、私の周りの、まあ、私の友達なんかの話を聞くと、
うん、
やはり、東電に勤めてる社員がいたりとか、
うん、
まあ、あとその要は友人がいるとか、
あ
るいは関連会社も含めてですね、そういうお友達とかたくさん持ってる方っていうのは、やはり例えば反原発的な感覚があっても、それを全面的に打ち出せない部分は当然、理解できますので。
So in that, the one of the reason why the people of Fukushima cannot really stand out is because, fortunately, Taka-san does not have friend who or family member, who works for the TEPCO or TEPCO related company, but there are many people who have their friends or family member works for TEPCO or TEPCO related company, nuclear power plant related company. So the complex relationship also led difficult to for stand out. But by that mean is that so many people in Fukushima are involved in the nuclear power industry then. じゃあ、ということは、その、タカさん的には、かなりの人が、その、原発関連の、かなりの福島のかなりの、なんていうのかな、方が原発関連と関係してるってことですか？
関係しているようですね。
It seems so that majority of the number of the people of Fukushima are like related to the nuclear power plant industry. So that's also one of the reasons that people cannot really stood out. I see. なるほどね。So in a way, they are the victim.But at the same time, they also the one who works for the nuclear industry. So they are on the other side as well. They are standing on the both side. つまり福島の人たちは被害者でもありつつも加害者側というか微妙な立場、両方のサイドに立っているかもしれないって感じですよね。
そうですね。例えばその従業員、例えばその関連会社を含めた従業員である方もたくさんいらっしゃるでしょうし、もう一つは取引先が東京電力さんという、零細中小企業も、福島あるいは隣接県茨城県とかそういったところにもありますので、そういったところはやはり声を大にして反原発という歌い方をされてないのではないかと。
なるほど。I see。あ、ごめんなさい。最後。何て言います？すみません。
そういう、そうですね。要は隣接地域の方も含めて、福島県だけではなくて、例えば、北側の宮城県もそうだし、あるいは南側の茨城県もそうです。茨城県だと日立がありますので、日立はやはり原発と原発、福島原発とその企業としての取引とかが大口でやっているはずですので、そういうこう関連を見ると、福島だけではなくて隣接の県も含めて、反原発という声を高々には上げれない事情があるとは思いますね。
I see.I see. So according to Taka-san, so not only Fukushima, like there's a Hitachi, like in the south of Fukushima, in Tochigi. Tochigi ですよね。
栃木は若干離れてますけど、まあ、隣接で、まあ、原発に直接的な、あの、宮城ですね、宮城。
宮城。
はい、仙台の宮城ですね。
宮城、栃木、surrounding prefecture as well. Many people work for a company who has a relationship with TEPCO, who has a relationship with the nuclear industry of Japan. So that's also one of the reasons why they cannot really say much to the people. And oh man, this is deep. まあ深いですね。
あの今みんな、まあ私もそうなんですけども、今そのこうどうしなきゃいけないというか、どうなるのかという、その非常にこう気になる部分っていうのは、
うん、
その今は、
うん、
反原発という、
うん、
そのベクトルよりも、
うん、
その汚染されたものを、
うん、
どのようにこうクリアしていくのか、
うん、
あるいは、生活の中で対応しなければいけないのか、
うん、
避難しなければいけないのか、
うん、
そこを、やらなければいけないという思いのが強いですね。うん、
So instead of moving to anti-nuclear,it's more about how to protect themselves from the radiation contamination, safety, evacuation if they have to. So they pretty much fed up with taking care of themselves. So it's not really about anti-nuclear movement.でもまああのその but however you know usually people from overseas in order to protect themselves they need to raise their voices to protect themselves but they are questioning Japanese people that why they are not raising their voices though でもあのその海外の人がその疑問に思ってるのが、つまり自分たちを守るためには、その例えばきちっとした情報をよこせとかいうためにもデモをしなきゃいけないんですよ。デモをするんですよね。
はい。
だからそのきちっとした情報をくれと。それが分かっそれがなのに、そのもっときちっとした情報が欲しいのならば、なおさらデモをしなきゃいけない、デモンストレーションとかをしなきゃいけない、なんでそれをしないのかっていうのをその疑問に思ってるんですよね。だからそれをどうやって説明したらいいかっていうね。だから自分そのうん。So why? So if you want to protect yourself.If you want to know the accurate information about the radioactive contamination, you need to ask the government. You need to ask the local government. You need to ask the TEPCO to provide the information. But that's why you need to do the demonstration, though. But why people are not doing the demonstration? なんででしょうね。だからそのね、安全かどうかっていうのをあの知るためには行動を起こさなきゃいけないじゃないですか。
うん、
でそのだから海外の人にとっては行動、その知るための行動がデモなんですよ、
うん、
政府に対する、うん、だってそうじゃないですか。あの当然
多分ですね、うん、あのこの原発、要は大震災あるいは原発事故、
うん、
それ以前の問題としてあったのが、
うん、
その政治不信的な部分っていうのは、
あ
こう流れが、そういう流れがあったと思うんですね。
あ
で政治不信という不信に思っている市民というのは、
うん、
そういうそのパフォーマンスを起こす気にもならない。
あなるほどね。
そういうところに気持ちがあれば、
うん、
そのデモをやっても、
うん、
打っても響かない鐘ならば、
うん、
それだけのエネルギーを持つ気にもならないというのが、 あるのではないでしょうか。
I see, I see. So, even before this nuclear crisis happened, Japanese people just don't trust the politics. So, but even Japanese people now came to the state that even though they made some action to move the government, but they don't trust the government in at the first place. So, they feel that it's going to be a waste of time.That they are, yeah, that's the good question. Yeah. But at the same time, also, I think that we are just too tired to deal with it because we not only the Fukushima nuclear crisis happened, but I think because we did have a huge earthquake and tsunami damage as well. So I think not only the we don't have, I think it's a complex reason that the earthquake and tsunami and then nuclear power plant incident, I think made us tired to make any action, just pretty much busy to keep ourselves tired, I think. だから多分もう僕らその忙しいんですよね。もうあの原発だけじゃなくて、地震とかもありましたからね、津波と。多分それで忙しあの疲れてるんですよ。疲れてるんでしょうかねって思うんですけどね。
そうですね。あの例えば地震で家が、
うん。
崩れたり傾いたり、
うん、
まあ私の親戚にも家がもうなんていうんですかね、うん、半壊状態、
うん、
住んでは住めるけども半壊状態、
うん、
そういった方もいらっしゃいますし、
うん、
でそういった方ってねやはり家の方が心配だということと、
うん、
あとはその原発が またボカンとならんじゃないかということの心配なので、
うん、
そのエネルギーをですね、
うん
反原発デモというところにはなかなか、
うん、
行かない。
そうやね。So, Mark, your voice sounds very tired. Yeah, I'm tired too. まあ僕も疲れてるんですけど。so, he said that some of his relative also his house got damaged. So some of his relative is too busy.To rebuild their life themselves, so they don't have time to go to like anti-nuclear action and stuff too. So the people who have to make action, the people of Fukushima, who is the victim of the nuclear power plant, and they have to make action. They also kind of have to take care of, too busy to take care of themselves as well. まあ、とにもかくにも。被災して忙しいってことですよね。
そうですね。うん、あのそうですね。あの戦おうとか、
うん、
なんていうの、白黒はっきりさせようじゃないかとか、
うん、
そういう意識にいけない。
うん、we are kind of too tired to bring ourselves up to the state that we need to fight.Or, you know, that kind of stuff. Yeah, so that's... Yeah. Okay, so I think I have to finish up. じゃあ、タカさん、あの11時にアルジャジーラと打ち合わせしなきゃいけないので、
はい、
あのそろそろ終わっちゃいましょう。ということで、あのスカイプのテストをしなきゃいけないので、
はい、
はい、じゃあ本当にあのありがとうございました。
いえいえ、こちらこそ。
So now it's about getting to 11 o'clock and I need to have a session with Al Jazeera because we do a Skype test and everything. So I need to finish today's live cast, everyone. So thank you for watching the 311 disaster update. It has been Taka from ibreezeiwaki.net, ibreezeiwaki from Iwaki, Fukushima, Japan, to give us the latest update of what's going on in Iwaki. And we had a discussion about what it is like that. All right, cool. So, じゃあ、タカさん、どうもありがとうございました。
はい、ありがとうございます。いや、
失礼します。また、後ほど。
はい。
はい。So, we'll、はい、talk later. All right, thank you very much, タカさん。
はい、はい、ありがとうございました。
失礼します。All right, thank you very much, everyone. This is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. I'm going to wrap up, folks. Thank you for watching the 311 disaster update. And from starting about 6.5 hours, I will be on Al Jazeera's English channel's D stream to give you the latest update of Japan. And then the next live cast of Yokoso News is scheduled on Sunday to talk about the to talk about World Cosplay Summit wrapping up. We're going to wrap up the World Cosplay Summit coverage of this year as well. So some fun stuff coming up as well. So thank you very much for watching, everyone. I'm going to wrap up now. It's time to say goodbye. Please like us at Yokoso News on Facebook, or please follow us at Yokoso News on Twitter. If something happens, I will give you the latest updates through them and as well. So thank you very much for watching. I'm tired. But I'm tired because I went to World Cosplay Summit and have fun, and I checked out the Giant Salamander Festival yesterday. Have fun. So this is good tired as well. Okay. So, okay, everyone. So, thank you for watching. I think, is that the Al Jazeera calling me? I think. All right, I need to get off now. All right, everyone. So, thank you for watching, and see you guys next week. Henry Monsan, thank you. Thank you, Mark. See ya. See you next week. Bye bye.